Hello friends, it's Terry with Terry's Mailbox, and today I'm presenting four cut cardstock. So I created this envelope box with four matching note cards inspired by Kath Stewart, who is one of Tim Holtz's makers. So again, here is the envelope box, and you can see it's got lots of layers and colors and dimension on it. So I started with a piece of 8.5 by 8.5 heavyweight distress cardstock, and again I wanted the heavier weight for the box, so again I scored it at the coordinating lines and then added 3/8 of an inch so that I could actually form a box here for my cards. So I started by ink schmooshing the background. So I've got antique linen, old paper, and shabby shutters, and again I'm just kind of schmooshing them on my cardstock or on my craft mat. And we're going to go ahead and spritz it and run my fingers through it to break up all the squares there. And we'll start pressing and schmooshing and inking and spritzing and drying. And, you know, just again, I'm just trying to get a color base on there, because, of course, I'm going to stamp on top of it with the Cracks and Specks stamp, and also then the Botanic Collage stamp. So next thing I did was I put it in my my messy box here, and I spritzed it with some of the mustard color ink spray, and then I splattered it with some of the Flickering Candlestick and the Jack-O-Lantern Mica. So again, here are the four cards. So I'm using that Botanic Collage stamp that I think is just gorgeous, and I'm coloring it on Savoy 100% cotton, which kind of acts like a great watercolor paper. And then there's that Specks and Cracks stamp that I'm going to use on the background. So the first thing I did was I put them in the box, and I just kind of spritzed them with some oxide sprays and some regular ink sprays, just to kind of get the color on there. So I did that with all four of the Savoy bases that I'm using. So again, just kind of antique linen, and then it's also it's not dried marigold, it's another yellow. And so we'll go ahead and put it on there, and then we'll go ahead and heat dry. And then there's that Crack and Speckle number 186. From Stampers Anonymous. So we'll go ahead and stamp that on the background with tea dye. And you'll see I'm not using a stamp positioner. I'm just kind of putting it on there, because again, it doesn't have to be a perfect, complete stamp. Again, I'm just using that for interest. And I did also stamp the envelope box with this same stamp. So again, we're just kind of putting it on here. And the next thing I did was I grabbed those four different stamps from the Botanic Collage, and then we'll go ahead and specifically add ink to the different sections. So like I'm using dried marigold and cracked campfire here on the bloom, along with tea dye, and then mowed lawn there for the background. So we're kind of just adding, you know, very specific places. And so once I've got it all inked up, then we will go ahead and spritz it once, and then go ahead and stamp it onto that Savoy cardstock. And again, you'll see that you don't get, you know, you get kind of a messy, inky type of image on there. So there's all four of them. And you can see I used the four different images to do that. Now here's that cute little butterfly. That's mini detailed butterflies from Sizzix. And so I cut those out to add on. Before I finished the card, I put it back in the box and spritzed it with some of that Flickering Candlestick and Jack-O-Lantern Mica spray to add some interest there. And again, I just took the top off, and I'm using the tube at the bottom. So again, I'm using a stitch die to cut it down just a little bit. And then I'm actually using a craft, Royal Sundance craft base for the base of the cards, with dark orange cardstock for that outline. And so I use black licorice cardstock here to make the butterfly. So again, I've got that black outline, and then I die cut the base out of a piece of ink schmooshed background that I have in my stash. If you follow me, you know I talk about my background stash quite a bit, and it's just really fun to fun to do that. So again, I'm trying to figure out, okay, which stamp do I want to put on the envelope? Because of course, in this gorgeous set, I need to have a stamped envelope. So again, those are craft envelopes. So I'm going to go ahead and do the same kind of inking and coloring there with the dried marigold and the cracked campfire and the tea dye. Or no, actually, that's brush corduroy, excuse me. So again, I'm inking and stamping, and then here I am putting them together. So there's that dark orange cardstock in the middle. You can see I also have several thankful sentiments that I've cut out of the black licorice cardstock already. So again, I'm going to go ahead and just use my tape runner here. Make sure I get it right side up, right? You ever done that? Put a card together and realized you put it together upside down? Yeah, I've done that. So again, I'm just taking my my glue here and just adding it on to the thankful so that I can put that on the front, lower front of the cards. And again, other than the fact that the stamps are different, all four of the cards are exactly the same. And then we're going to go ahead and take the butterfly and kind of fold him up. And I'm only going to glue down the body because I want him to kind of have a little bit of depth and dimension to him. So again, here is that envelope box. I'm showing you the complete thing and how it opens. I've got a piece of distress inked seam binding there. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4 cards. And then the coordinating envelopes. 3, 4 cards. And then the coordinating envelopes. So I hope you've enjoyed my tutorial today. Again, it's Terry with Terry's Mailbox. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and Blogger. Would love to have you come and follow me. Have a great day.